Next question is from Jay Hines 62. What are the consequences of eating below the minimum daily requirement of fat?
You know, not good.
Yeah, could be hair, skin, hormones.
Yeah, fat and protein are essential. Okay, that your body cannot make certain fatty acids that it needs for hormone production, for nerve development, for brain function, for connective tissue support, and all that stuff. Same thing with protein. There's certain amino acids the body cannot make. In other words, if you don't get the adequate amount or the minimum amount of fat that your body needs, the consequences can become very, very dire. Okay, this is not true for carbohydrates. Those are not essential. Not saying that you might not suffer from some, you know, performance issues or whatever if you drop your carbs, but you're not gonna have major health issues like if you don't eat enough proteins and fats. You don't see this as much these days, but especially when fat was demonized, this was something that I saw with female clients.
It was very common.
Yeah, I would see that, you know, they'd have the dry skin, hair loss was one, their inability to feel full, they were always hungry, mental fatigue was a big one, and if they got tested for their nutrients, you would see that their fat-soluble vitamins, you know, A and D, for example, would be kind of low. So the consequences are really not good if you don't get adequate fat. You need it. Your body absolutely needs it to thrive.
I had several female clients that this was the key that unlocked us breaking plateaus. You know, for months I, you know, was managing calories on them. Training's going good. I know everything should be lining up that we should be seeing results, and their body was just staying stuck. And I remember looking at fat and going like, oh, you know what? You know, her fat's really low. I wonder if I boost her fat up a little bit. And I remember the first couple times I did that, and it was mm-hmm. the key that just unlocked their body to start responding then again. So, you know, you just got to remember that, like, everything works together. So it's like a car engine. When something is off, like the timing belt is off, the car sounds different, it runs different, it feels different. Our bodies are similar in that way, where, you know, even though this is maybe there's not something related to fat that is like directly correlated to your metabolism, but if things aren't operating smoothly, it can and will affect those things. And sometimes it's that simple for some clients that, oh wow, you've been under consuming on an essential macronutrient for so long that your body's not performing optimally. It's not running optimally. And just by me kind of boosting that up a little bit, all of a sudden the body fat starts coming off, energy levels, skin feels better, notice hair, like all these things started to change.
Yeah, you also could, I'll get clients who feel cold all the time. I had a couple female clients who had fertility issues. We bumped their fat intake mm-hmm. up and they mm-hmm. got pregnant. In men, I've seen low testosterone. So I've had male clients who don't eat enough fat, and they come to me with their testosterone readings, and we just bump their fat intake, and lo and behold, their testosterone levels go up. Sleep is another one. Not being able to sleep because you don't have enough fatty acids.
It reminds me of, what was it, like late 80s, early 90s, the whole low fat, like mm-hmm. everybody was like so concerned about eating any fat. And that was like a big push that you were, because you eat fat, you're going to get fat. And like, I'm just wondering where this question, you know, is coming from in terms of like what type of diet strategy they're trying to implement. If there's other, you know, like I know vegans, like obviously there's going to be a big push to find fats from vegetables and find fats out there that they can get that aren't from animal products, but still you got to do a lot of hunting to make sure that you're getting adequate amounts. So I'm sure that is a bit of a struggle.
Yeah. Omega-3 fatty acids are what vegans typically need to supplement, because it's really hard to get those from vegetable sources. You can get sources that convert to that, but it doesn't do a very good job. But yeah, not eating enough fat is a bad idea.
Yeah.
It can cause some real problems. If it's for a short period of time, it's not a big deal, but you definitely don't want to go too low.